for more than 20 years.
Oh yeah, that's a lot better, a lot straighter.
Louis Tuccio has worked at the Oneida Price Chopper.
My favorite part about the Price Chopper is the carts. I'm great with the carts. I'm faster. It's just the best ever.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
And Tuccio is a big fan of his coworkers.
It's nice. It's great. It's fun working with everybody. Everybody's nice. We have a lot of fun working together. We have a lot of good times, a lot of good laughs.
Despite his lengthy tenure at the Price Chopper, his hours are being drastically cut.
We get past the fiscal year, the hours, 4 hours a week. That's stressing me out, Matt, and I'm a good worker. I work hard here.
If the hours are at 4 a week now, they could go down further. If Tuccio is unemployed, getting a job with a disability is a tough road. Just ask Oneida couple, Alicia Flynn, and Mike Miles.
It was very hard. Like, right now, to try and find a job on your own, they're not actually hiring, like, the disabled.
And it's not for lack of trying. He needs to provide for his son, James.
How many applications I put out, I must have put out, like, tons. Sometimes twice at the same place after a while, and still nothing.
Although Miles eventually found a job with the help of the ARC, his job coach says the job market is becoming more and more complicated.
Because jobs have become multifunction, where it used to be someone maybe in Burger King or McDonald's just cleaning tables. Now they need to run register, maybe take orders to things that they aren't comfortable with.
Tuccio and Miles are part of the 30% of the disabled population in Central New York with jobs. But compare that to 69% of the able-bodied population. That's a wide discrepancy. Organizations such as the Burton Blatt Institute at Syracuse University's campus is trying to decrease that gap.
Overall mission statement of the Burton Blatt Institute is to promote the civic, social, and economic participation of people with disabilities.
Ramsey lives with a visual impairment and knows the struggle of getting a job all too well.
Because of my disability, I felt they wouldn't want to hire me because, he can't, work the cashier or whatnot. So there were certain things where I didn't even apply just because of reservations I had myself.
Now he's pushing for young people with disabilities to get the training they need, and a big part of that is the BBI's partnership with Onondaga Community College's Pathways to Careers, or OPC.
They are working to make sure that the students are aware that they have to have certain professional skills before they complete their degree requirements. Even simple things like building a resume and assisting with job searching and obtaining internships while they are studying as well.
One of those students is J.D. Wentling.
I was born with autism, and I have a lot of testing requirements going on here with my disability.
Some things he struggles with.
But sometimes I get little difficulties with based on communication sometimes.
But the OPC is right there with him.
OPC will be there to help out for them, for any students, based on if they have a lack of experience, lack of transportation, and lack of communications. They've been helping me focus on what any good jobs I could be able to good at.
JD hopes to enter the hospitality industry after college, and the OPC got him an internship.
The Embassy Suites was a good hotel experience for me. A lot of nice staffs, nice employees, and they have the perfect requirements I wanted to be interested in.
The job market can be stressful all on its own. Finding, maintaining, or training. Having a disability may add to that stress, but
it can be a disability, but it doesn't have to be, because I'm visually impaired, but I get around. I've done plenty so far in my young life. So I think it's a matter of just how you see it.
Matt St. Jean, NCC News.